Welcome to the Spy Collection Digital Edition. This is Anastasios and today's digital artifact comes from the files leaked by Edward Snowden and was first publicly released in 2015 by The Intercept in this article you see here. It is an old training slide deck on DNI, or digital network intelligence. It doesn't have a date on it, but we can safely assume that it is more than a decade old. Thus, it has some historical value in understanding how NSA signals intelligence analysts would onboard in those earlier days of DNI. Imagine that you just joined the NSA as an intelligence analyst in the early days of cyber-enabled operations. Everyone is all over this new DNI, the digital network intelligence, but you aren't sure where to start. Just for reference, DNI is any information collected from communications between computer networks. This slide deck was a DNI 101 created by an NSA contractor from Booz-Allen Hamilton consulting firm. Fun fact, this was one of the companies Edward Snowden worked for too when he was at the NSA as a contractor. The objective of that Booz-Allen Hamilton project was to create some sort of mind map for new DNI analysts looking to what to do when they have an email address potentially belonging to a target. In this example, the jihadi@mail.com. So where do you start? So I reconstructed the slide deck to add some transitions, and here is what we have. On the bottom right, we have the color coding, purple indicating a tool or a database, and green showing its signals intelligence value. Then, on the bottom left, it makes an important note to make the analyst understand the difference between targeting someone and researching someone. Targeting is looking for information on a specific individual or group in order to create a targeting package, that is, an intelligence product on all the information required to take some action against a target. So this means querying very sensitive information in the raw format. On the other hand, research is way more generic and uses mainly open source information. The aim was to triage what you're looking for, identify if it's really a threat, and then move to targeting. So indeed, there is a huge difference between targeting and researching. That said, let's start with the actual content. As mentioned, it all starts with a target email address. In this case, the example is jihadi@mail.com. The first thing a DNI analyst could do is to consider if this is relevant to USSID 18, host country restrictions. USSID 18 stands for United States Signals Intelligence Directive 18 and defines the policy for signals intelligence on US persons. I leave a link in the description if you want to read what is and what is not allowed. At that time, the NSA analysts could use two internal tools for this. NKB, or Network Knowledge Base, which was literally a database with such information, or Foreman, a signals intelligence database used to differentiate United States persons from foreigners. Assuming that the analyst was legally allowed to proceed, they would first start with the research. The first step was to use open source collection from things like searching on Google, looking at publications, etc. If that wasn't sufficient, the analyst could use some classified resources. For example, they could use Ankory, an NSA software which was parsing text from all the websites and allowed quick searching, or Proton, a CIA system for quick metadata searches, etc. And what were they after? Is any relevant selectors, as they were called. That is, unique information which could be used to filter or select the communications of interest and then perform analysis on the results. Examples of that you see here, names, numbers, addresses, and so on. Okay, so you finished your research and you are confident that you discovered an intelligence target. What do you do next? Well, you verify if someone had already done this. In other words, has someone already tasked NSA systems with monitoring this person? If yes, then what kind of tasking is already in place? Is it near real-time tipping, which is typical in CT, counter-terrorism targets? In this case, then information would have been in the NSA systems mentioned here. Just for reference, near real-time tipping is when the selectors are checked against all incoming data, and if there is a match, they immediately notify the analysts, For example, a new email, a new phone call, a new social media post, etc. Is it tasked for passive collection? And this means interception of communications that the NSA has access to and just recording everything as the communications pass through them. Was it for active collection, which means things like intercepting traffic from hacked devices, networks, etc.? And finally, was it tasked for FAA, meaning the Section 702 of the Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Act? If you want a better understanding of this, I highly recommend you to check out my NSA Prism video. In short, it means data collected through this authority, which, among others, included the collection of data from many corporations, network links and others. Let's say that you did your verification, but you either didn't find your target there, or you need some further analysis on the raw communications traffic. The first option would be to utilize an office of the NSA known as the Tailored Access Operations, who, in an oversimplified manner, can be described as the hackers of the agency, and ask them to hack any required systems and start providing raw intelligence from there. If you want to find out the content of the target's communications, like what it was inside their emails, their messages, their phone calls, etc., you could use the systems mentioned here. On the other side, if your focus was on metadata, like with whom they were talking with, and when, what websites they visited, and so on, then the path would be this one, and the tools are the ones mentioned here. Now the results of that could be viewed using the tools you see here. And combined, we have the research, the verification, and the targeting. And as the slide says, so you did all that, and now you are finding results. Great, now what? The DNI analyst now has an idea and multiple selectors for this target to use. And this is what the next and the final slide is about. For example, if they manage to discover any IP addresses, what they could do is do signals development. That is, try to see what networks are related to. This could help them analyze location information using tools like the ones mentioned here. They could find out which internet provider was used, using NSLookup. They could also find out traffic routing information using trace routes. They could find the best collection points in order to intercept more communications. And if they found any of those, they should document them as SIGADs, or Signals Intelligence Activity Designator case notations. They could use the tools mentioned here to do that. But what if they discovered any cookies on the web communications? In this case, that could help them figure out if there were any other email accounts related to this computer. For example, if the same cookies were seen in multiple sessions on different accounts. That could be done with the tools mentioned here. What about phone numbers? The same thing, XG-score could be used to further extend the analysis. Further information on phone numbers could also be retrieved from various different classified databases, like the ones mentioned here. What about websites they use? Well, in this case, they could use again the XG-score, which could be oversimplified as a search engine on classified databases. And that could help identify the ownership or registration of those websites. This could be achieved also with publicly available tools like domain and Whois lookups. The same for the hosting information, like where are those websites being hosted, what's running there, are they relevant to the US SID 18? If not, then further research can be made. Are they affiliated with any organizations or companies? What about the site content itself? While looking to the site's content, can you find any other EEIs or essential elements of information, like emails, phone numbers, names? What if you were able to discover more email addresses or phone numbers? Then you just restart this process. And what happens when you have things that you don't understand on how to further investigate? Well, in this case, you are going to the more senior people, like the tech leads, to help you proceed with your investigation. You could search on the web and try to find references. And this was the completion of this quick DNI 101. After performing all of this work, the DNI analyst should be able to create a targeting package for the person or the group they were investigating. Please note that most, if not all, of what was listed there is almost certainly outdated, but hopefully that helped you get a better understanding of some of the complexities of DNI intelligence analysis, even for agencies with such extensive access as that of the NSA. Nevertheless, this gives a glimpse into the secret spy world, which is continuously looking at anything that could harm a country's national security and interests, ideally without anyone finding it out. But nothing is as it seems.